In this pandemic era, I do not want to go to the hospital, even if I have some kind of vaginal discharge or some problem in my private parts. So let's discuss today how to examine your vagina yourself. I'm Dr. Aruna Kalra, Director of Obstetrics and Gynecology at C.K. Birla Hospital, Gurgaon. If you want to examine your vagina yourself, you can do it. We have to know what is the time best to examine your vagina yourself. There are few points. One thing is that you should not be bleeding. So once your menstrual cycle is over, say after 5 or 7 days of your last day would be the best time to examine your vagina when there is no blood streak inside. And then you should not be using any cream, fragrant or otherwise, or any kind of vaginal pessary 2 or 3 days prior to examination. You should not be using or doing vaginal douche before, again, 2 to 3 days before your vaginal examination, because we need to know what exactly is the problem there. So we need a natural vagina there. Now, if we have selected a day, what should be the position? What are we actually looking for in vagina? Do we know how normal or normal vagina looks like, or how normal vulva looks like? We should know first what is normalcy to rule out what is abnormal. So first, let us tell you what is the position, in which position you should be sitting. Your back should be rested either against the wall or bed. Your legs should be wide apart. You should be having a long handled mirror with you. And once you have positioned yourself, your legs and feet should be near your bums. It is called lithotomy, supine lithotomy position. You should place yourself in that position. Now, what you're looking for? The two fleshy lips are vulva, which are normal smooth muscle. And then where they are attaching interiorly or upper portion is called clitoris. Downside would be your anal region. And then there is above there would be pubic bone and pubic hair. If everything is normal, if there is no ulcer, no small vesicles or boils, it looks like a smooth skin-like as your thigh. Inside the vagina looks like a pink rugosity structure. What is rugosity? Once you feel your upper part of mouth, like hard palate with your skin, there is a roughness in the skin, which is called rugosity. Inside a vagina also feels rugosity like feeling. So you should know this should be a thin, light pink color, which you're looking for in vagina. The color should be light pink and it feels like a rough structure, and you can always compare it with when you feel your hard palate. That is a normal vagina. But if you feel there is some kind of smooth cyst, that is abnormal. If there are ulcers, that is abnormal. If there are small punctate lesions or boils, that is abnormal. This might be some kind of wart-like structure, which are skin growths. That is also not painful, but abnormal structures there. There is a normal vaginal discharge, which is thin, white, light, a little opaque or mucoid discharge. It can have a little acidic smell, like a little pungent vinegar, like vinegar smell. Okay, but if there is abnormal discharge, it would be fishy in smell. It would be thin, greenish, very watery one, or it can be flaky, curdy, cheesy like discharge, which can be fungal. So thin greenish discharge, which is fishy, can be trichomonal or bacterial. Curdy, cheesy can be fungal discharge. So once we know that what is abnormal discharge from normal discharge, we can tell our doctor that this is what I'm feeling or I have seen, and accordingly your doctor would be able to prescribe you medicines. Yes, there are disadvantages of self-vaginal examination and there are advantages also. Like if we are worried about exposure to nosocomial infection or COVID infection, and we are able to diagnose ourselves, or we are able to show to our doctor what exactly are my signs of infection, it would be good that you should know and you should be able to convey that. But if you are not able to, please do not take unnecessary antibiotics or without confirming the type of discharge, whether it's bacterial or fungal. Do not take antibiotics inadvertently. So all the very best to you. I hope that you are able to diagnose your vaginal infection yourself, and we are there to help you. Thank you.